Good morning, children. This is English video session for class 10, and we are dealing with the topic First Flight, and the story is 100 dresses. Okay, now we are now dealing about the problem in the mind of Maddie, who is not able to bear the way she behaves with Wanda, and unfortunately she is not able to stop Peggy to do all these things to Wanda, to behave badly with Wanda, to make funny remarks on her, to call her and ask how many dresses, all these things she wanted it to stop. Is that clear, children? Yes. Shall we understand? Shall we go? Another thing, Peggy is the most liked student on the entire class. Okay, she is best liked, and so she doesn't want to give up that friendship also. So she is little not able to understand what she really wanted to do now. Next. Okay, now let's see what happens. As far as Wanda, she was just some girl who lived in Boggin Heights and stood alone in the schoolyard. She scarcely ever said anything to anybody. The only time she talked in the schoolyard about her 100 dresses. Maddie remembered her telling about one of her 100 dresses, pale blue with colored trimmings, and she remembered another, that brilliant jungle green with red sash. "You'd look like a Christmas tree," that the girls had said in and pretended admiration. So whenever she said, "Come on, tell me about your dress," the girls will be asking, "You tell me." So Wanda used to explain about the color combination of the dresses, pale blue color trimmings, cuts and other frills, and she used to tell about the color of the green and red. And people used to tell that it's like a Christmas tree. You will look like a Christmas tree. And they will be wondering, how could she speak like that? Okay. They were all wondering why she is not wearing any of those, wearing the same dress to the school, but she's saying has 100 dresses. Are you able to understand, children? What is the, why these children are doing like that? Yes. Let's see what happened next. Thinking about Wanda and her 100 dresses all lined up in the closet, Maddie began to wonder who was going to win the drawing competition, the dresses and for the boys and designing motorboats. Probably Peggy would win girls' medal. Peggy drew better than anyone in the room. At least that was what everybody thought. She would copy a picture from the magazine or from the film star head so that you could almost tell who it was. Oh, Maddie was sure Peggy would win. Well, tomorrow the teacher was going to announce the winners and they would know. Now, listen, children, there is a competition. The teacher announces about the competition. What was the competition about? It was about the, yes, the teacher is going to, yes, what was it? 100 dresses. Maddie began to wonder who is going to win the drawing and coloring contest. What is the name of the competition? Drawing and coloring competition. Okay, children. So children are all going to participate in it. Let's see what happened. Who thinks that, what is Peggy thinking? Who is going to win the particular program, event? It should definitely be Peggy. Where does she get the picture? From the magazine. Somewhere she will take the picture and she will draw it so beautifully, and she would only win. Let's see what happens. The next day it was drizzling. What is drizzling, children? Mild rain. So, you know, not very much raining. We can walk through the rain. Okay. The next day it was drizzling. Maddie and Peggy hurried to school under the Peggy's umbrella. So, Peggy had an umbrella. So, Maddie was hurrying herself under the Peggy's umbrella. Naturally, on that day like this, they didn't wait for Wanda Petronsky on the corner of the Oliver Street. Usually, they wait near the Oliver Street, the street that was far away under the rail track and up the hill led to the Boggin Heights. That was the place how you have to go through the Boggin Heights. So So they were not ready to wait because first it is raining and already they were late to the class. Okay, they weren't taking class chances on being late today because today was important. Why? It's going to be a most important day because the results will be announced. The details of the students participating in the competition will be announced. So they are quite inquisitive of what is happening on that day. They did not bother whether Wanda had come or not. They hurried to the classroom. Okay children, shall we continue what happened next? Yes. Do you think Miss Mason will announce the winners today? Asked Peggy. Oh, I hope so. So the minute we get in, said Mary. Of course you will win, Peggy. Hope so, Peggy eagerly. So what did she say? Yes, there is a possibility that I may win. So it is always confirmed the truth that it is always Peggy who will be the winner, and she will be able to do everything fine. It is always like that. Okay, and who is Miss Mason? Miss Mason is none other than the teacher, their teacher. Okay, shall we see what happens next? Actually, who wins the competition? Yes, do you know? Let's see. The minute they entered the class, they stopped short and gasped. There were drawings all over the room, on every ledge and the windowsill, dazzling colors and brilliant, lavish designs, all drawn on great sheets of wrapping paper. There must have been hundreds of them all lined up. They must be the drawings for the contest. They were. Everybody stopped and whistled and murmured admiring. So she thought her painting will be there and 2-3 paintings will be there and she is going to win. But once she entered the room, they couldn't even breathe. Shocking thing. Windows everywhere, you can see the paintings. Okay. And where the sheets of wrapping paper, all drawn on great sheets of wrapping paper. So it is all thick. Okay. They can keep drawing on it. Yes. They are all contesting for the drawing competition. Everybody was just looking with shock and admiration what it is. As soon as the class is assembled, Miss May announced the winner. Jack Beggles has won the boys, and he has the design of the outboard motor and was in the exhibition room number 12. So room number 12, he has won the exhibition for 12 along with the sketches of the boys. It was put up. Okay, so who was the winner of the boys? Jack Beggles. Okay, that is the outboard motor. Design on the outboard motor. Okay, now what is for the girls? Now the result for the girls. As for girls, she said, although just one or two sketches were submitted by most, one girl and room 13 should be proud of her. This one girl actually drew 100 designs, all different and all beautiful. In the opinion of the judges, any one of the drawing is worthy the winning of the prize. I'm very happy to say Wanda Petronsky is the winner of the girl's medal. My goodness, what a lovely thing. She has won the... So what all she said, now you are able to understand children. 100 designs, blue color, red color, jungle green, cherry red, whatever, everything was before them. Now tell children, was she telling a lie? Was it a lie which she told? No, that was not a lie. She was all true that Petronsky has with her. See the picture? Yes, see how she is doing beautifully in all those package papers. She did not waste them. She made it straight and she drew everything in it. And each one was different. There were no sort of similarity in any dress. They had different designs, different colors, combinations, different models and cuts. Everything was different. See the picture? Are they same? The neck is different, the hands are different, the hip portion is different, the sleeves are different, the end embroidery is different, the cuts are different, the frills are different. One was different. Amazing. Is it not? It's really amazing. Yes. I'll stop here. Have a look at those dresses, children. So beautiful. Yes.